County Council was to suspend any investigation for 12 months, and that's when you have a willing indictment. And we know that the United States has been vetoing the United States Attorney Council resolutions in order to protect Israel. We know that the United States has been bullying other countries using its economic and other power to apply pressure on various countries in order to vote certain ways, and have the U.S. United States not do Israel comfortable. my rights for the dying, the next lawyer deal with that kind of problem that we're up for you, and others that will step up to support you. To support you, so don't stop doing what you can in the spaces where you are to educate. To educate, to mobilize, and that you might face backlash, you might suffer a loss sometime, but you will not be alone. That I guarantee you, and you may be better off in the end. Because we don't want to keep serving the institutions that serve to oppress. They speak nicely, they speak words about freedom of speech and freedom and democracy and human rights, but when it comes down to it, they use their power to suppress. And they rely on the ability for the concern that these people have for facing such backlash in order to exert that kind of power over us. And when there are enough of us that refuse to go along with that, that is when these systems will break down. So I want to encourage you by telling you, when I started the International Solidarity Movement back in 2001, the movement for Palestinian rights was there, you know, but we have come, and I see a lot of young people now, it's such a long way, that I can say, I believe that victory is near, but that is only if we keep on. That we don't tire, we don't get discouraged, we don't despair. Briefly, I have a couple more minutes. I'm going to just say some only legal mechanisms that exist. I don't mean to also say that we can't use them now. We can and we have them. But just to give you an example, the way they've been shut down for families, there is something called the family ICC, there is something called the universal jurisdiction. Universal jurisdiction laws are, it's really a principle that any country or state can exercise general jurisdiction over someone who is believed to have committed heinous crimes. So you know that person doesn't have to live in your country, the crime doesn't have to happen, doesn't even have to be committed in your country. It goes back, it's based on the principle that certain crimes are so heinous that people shouldn't be able to get away with it. So wherever this person is, the state can exert jurisdiction and prosecute them criminally. And it has been used in Palestinian crime cases. In 2001, in Belgium, and there was a credible case there where victims of some kind of subpoena brought a case. But what happened? Political pressure again, so that the government changed its own laws so suddenly, to use universal jurisdiction, you have to have some kind of nexus to Belgium. So that case was shut down. Spain, the same thing. United Kingdom, the same thing. There is also domestic law, and I'm involved actually in one case against those who support Israeli settlements, which are war crimes. That case has been before the district court in D.C. for about 7 years now, but it's still open and it's still going, and there are lawsuits elsewhere. There's last week, actually 2 weeks ago, Senator Pelosi and the Reich filed a lawsuit against Biden and Blinken, against this administration for his laptop to the partner. For complicity in genocide. So we are still using the law. What I mean is that there will be political interventions probably to shut that down unless we can change it, but that doesn't mean we stop. Okay, that doesn't mean we stop. I think I'm going to end by just saying Palestine. We are Palestinian people who are all over the world. Exposed this farce that the West genocide.